Hi everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, insertion and action of the pectoralis major muscle. So we can see here, highlighted in red, the origins of the pectoralis major muscle. You can see here the anterior surface of the medial half of the clavicle, the anterior surface of the sternum, and the superior six costal cartilages of the ribs. So next, we can see right here the abdominal muscles, and covering the top of these abdominal muscles is going to be a thin but strong membranous structure, and this structure is called the aponeurosis of the abdominal external oblique muscle. And you can see the pectoralis major right here, and you can see in the inferior portion of it, it's actually tying in to this aponeurosis, and that's going to be our final origin of the pectoralis major. So again, that's the aponeurosis of the abdominal external oblique muscle. So lastly, we got highlighted here in blue the insertion of the pectoralis major muscle, and that's on the lateral crest of the bicipital groove. You might also know the bicipital groove as the intertubular groove. What that is, it's a indentation or a groove which runs down where I'm highlighting here. It runs down between the lesser and the greater tubercle of the humerus, and it's where the long head of the biceps brachii tendon passes through. Now, the pectoralis major muscle is going to insert on the lateral crest of this groove, so lateral side being towards this side and the crest being the top of the groove, so you dip down into it and you come back up to the top. So we're back again with the scatter model. We can see our origins of the pec major on the clavicle, the sternum and the superior six costal cartilages. We can see our insertion on the lateral lip of the bicipital groove. And let's go over the actions. So the actions are going to be primarily adduction. So we can see adduction here in a horizontal plane or a more vertical plane of movement. But pec major's major role is adduction. Let's move on to the next role, which is going to be internal rotation or medial rotation. So you can see this humerus is in an externally rotated position at the moment. That pec major is contracting, and that's contributing to internal rotation of the humerus. So internal rotation, just like that. Next, we've got elevating the humerus, so flexing this shoulder joint. The clavicular portion of the pectoralis major is going to contribute to this movement, obviously alongside other muscles such as the anterior head of the deltoid. So if you look over here though, we've got our sternocostal fibers, and when the humerus is elevated like this, those sternocostal fibers are going to be moving diagonally in this position. So when they contract, that's going to cause extension of the humerus. So we've also got extension of the humerus and flexion of the humerus towards shoulder joint here. So it's contributing to these two movements. Now, something to bear in mind though, is once we get down to a certain position with the humerus, once it's moved through a certain range of motion, these sternocostal fibers are no longer going to be contributing to extension of the humerus. So once it gets to a certain point, that emphasis is going to shift more towards your back muscles, those posterior muscles of the body. The pec major is not going to extend the humerus back here, for example. It's got a limitation. It's going to do it more when the humerus is elevated. That's when it's going to be able to contribute more to extension of the humerus. So that covers the pec major muscle. Thank you very much for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. And I'll see you all next time.